Greenhouse biodigesters, constructors of biodegradable waste biodigesters and general biodigester education right here in Accra, Ghana. This is a quick video just to explain to you or give you a simple trick when you are constructing a biodigester and then you are connecting it to a soak hole pit. Remember, we have the two different types or the three different types of soakaways that you can use for your biodigester. So basically, you do have the traditional soak hole pit, and then you have the connection to a traditional soakaway, and then obviously the one that you can connect to a gutter or a drainage system. So right now I'm at the site working, and I thought that let me just come and do this video and show you a simple trick that I've realized and I'm using in terms of constructing the soak hole pit for the biodigester. So usually what happens is that if you do a biodigester for a house and the land is good, it's loamy, it's not clay, it's not waterlogged, it's on a hilltop or a mountainous area, and then there's a lot of rocks and then you can work well, you can simply do a soak hole pit for the digester. A soak hole pit is the one that you have to put the stones in it and then use a rubber or carpet to cover the top before the sand goes on it. And it's hidden and it's buried under the earth surface, and then the leachate pipe will be connected into it. So in this case, what it means is that the water from the digester goes through the leachate pipe into the soak hole pit. And then because you are putting some stones and some blocks, broken blocks in it, it will help seep the water slowly into the earth surface. And then the digester will work fine, right? So remember, that's how we learn how to construct a biodigester. And there are some cases that it will not work. So if it's not going to work for you, it means that you need a traditional soakaway, or you need to have it pumped out in the soakaway, or you need to have it connected to a drainage system, which is for a longer use. But there are some situations that you meet, and then the digester is only for one toilet, or it's for only one or two people use, and then the land is also good as well. Instead of having an additional cost of constructing a traditional soakaway, you can do the soak hole pit for the person. So in this case, what I've realized and what I do now is I put a vent cap at the end of the leachate pipe or the 4-inch pipe that leads into the soak hole pit, so that dirt and debris will not enter and block the wastewater or the black water from entering the soakaway or the soak hole pit that I've dug. Usually what happens is that after some time, 4 or 5 years, 6 years, depending on the users or the capacity of the people who are using the register, you get choked, because sometimes you do pavement on that place or you do some tiling there and then you cover it and it's underneath the F, and at the time will come, probably some debris and things will enter it and then you get choked. But in this case, when you do construct the soak hole pit, just get the vent cap, either the 4-inch pipe vent cap or the 3-inch pipe vent cap, depending on which one you're using, as your leachate pipe, and then you put it at the end of it and then you lay it into the soak hole pit before you put the stones around it, the stones under it and some on it, and then you put the rubber on it nicely and then you cover it. What it does is that it guarantees the long-term use of this particular soak hole pit, and then your digester is guaranteed for a longer use for you and then the client or the homeowner you are doing this particular biodigester for. This is a channel dedicated to the construction of biodigesters and for homeowners who are interested in using it as an option, as a means in terms of managing their human wastewater. If you're new to the channel, subscribe. And the next video showing will give you a better idea and understanding of how biodigesters work and how you can use it as an option in managing your home and your wastewater.